And now putting all this thing there and come to the integral, we will solve this integral. And here, integral from 0 to L, 1 over 1 plus x squared over z squared whole power 3 over 2, and this one is dx. Now, we do some supposition in order to simplify this integral. Let's say x over z is equal to tangent theta. And I know from here as well that tangent theta is x over z. So I am just converting it into trigonometric form, because in trigonometric form the solution will become very easy. And then you square this one. So x square plus x square over z square, and this square this one and add 1 with this one, like 1 plus x square with z square. This will come out to be tangent square theta plus 1. And we know that 1 plus tangent square theta is equal to secant square theta. And this is equal to 1 over cos square theta. So we have done one conversion, and that one conversion is this one. Now again, I come to this one in order to, two things remains, because first is the calculation of our variable when we do convert it into another variable. The next calculation is of our dx, and then the final calculation will be of the limit, that what limit you are having. So here we have converted the variable. Now from here, x is equal to z tan theta, and if I find the dx here, dx will be equal to z in secant square theta and d theta. This is one of the conversion, that means the dx, the derivative of this one. So because z is constant here, and this is secant square theta and d theta. So for the dx, the terms are like this. And now what about the limits? I know that x is going from 0 to L. And here, when x is 0, then this is z here, and this is tangent theta. And this gives us the tangent theta is equal to 0. And tangent theta is, we know, let me do it. This means that tangent theta is equal to 0. And tangent is equal to sine theta over cos theta is equal to 0. It means that sine of theta is equal to 0. And sine of theta can be 0 when theta is equal to 0, the very first value we are taking. So it means that when x is equal to 0, like the limit I write, when x is 0 to L, then theta is, we are converting into theta, so theta is running from 0 to what? What will be the next value? The next value is that x is running to L. So x is equal to L, and this is z and tan theta. And this is equal to L over z. Tan theta is equal to L over z here. And then this implies that theta is equal to tan inverse L over z here. So tan theta is equal to L over tangent inverse in L over Z. Now I know that what is L over Z from here? L over Z, if I look from here, when X is equal to L, then L over Z is equal to tan theta. So it means again the same thing, that actually for when X is equal to L, then angle will go from 0 to theta. And here our limits are like this, that X goes from 0 to L while theta goes from 0 to theta, as we see here. Look here, when this hypod is at this point, when X goes from 0 to L here, then theta goes from 0 to theta, and that's why our limits are like this. So now coming back to the integral, and now our integral is, this implies integral from 0 to L, so this is from 0 to any value of theta. And then for dx, I can write here z secant square theta, z and secant square theta, d theta, divide by, what about 1 plus this square? So 1 plus tan square theta, this is secant square theta. So secant square theta power 3 by 2. Secant square theta power 3 over 2. And then this is equal from 0 to theta. And I can see here that this secant square theta, this 2 is cancelled with this 2. And we are left with secant square theta here and secant cube theta here, so we can simplify this one. Z will come outside, and then secant square theta by secant cube theta, and it will come out to be 1 over secant theta, and 1 over secant I can write is cos theta and d theta. So this thing is equal to Z, and cos theta is the derivative of sine theta. So I can write that this is sine theta from 0 to theta. And this is equal to z sine theta. Because sine theta and then sine 0 is 0. So this integral came out to be z sine theta here with us. And now come back to our actual position here. And our actual position here is that DE from this point, DE from this point, this implies that E, the electric field, comes out to be equal to 2 lambda Z here divided by 4 pi epsilon naught, 4 pi epsilon naught z cube. And then for this whole integral solution, I can write z sine theta. This is z sine of theta. Now I can do simplify the things, that here this one, this z is gone with this, z means z squared, so it's z squared, and then it is gone with here, and only one remains here. So this thing is equal to 2 lambda and sine of theta divided by 4 pi epsilon naught and z here. And now put the value of sine theta from here. The value of sine theta is x over r. So we are having the r value from here, that this is x over r, and for x we will write the value now equal to L because we have already put the limit here, and this thing will come out to be for sine theta, this is 2 lambda, and we got sine theta here, so this is L over x square plus z square, because here sine theta value I can put from here is L over 4 pi epsilon naught and z, and this is L over r. So L over r will make this thing equal to 1 over this is z square plus x square square root. So I have written this value here, 2 lambda 4 pi epsilon naught z here, 2 lambda here, and for sine theta I put L over r, and L over r is equal to this, and we are done with the solution of this. That electric field came out to be 2 lambda L 4 pi epsilon naught z z square plus x square, and it is in the z direction. If I want to write the direction here, then it will be in the z direction. Now we can do some approximation, and the approximation is such that for points far from the when the observation point is very far from the source, from the line segment, then I can write that when z is very very greater than L, then there will be approximation here, and the approximation will be, okay, I will have to change here this one as well, that this is actually L square, because as I have put for the x here L, so this will be L square as well. When this one is very very greater, then what will happen? We will have z square here, z square plus L square will go to z square, and z square power 1 over 2 will make this one a z, and z here and then one z here, it will become z squared. So we will have 1 over, this will imply that electric field for such a situation will be 1 over 4 pi epsilon naught and 2 lambda L over z square. Now here, if I look at this one, when you are very far from this one, then it converts almost to a point charge, because 1 over 4 pi epsilon naught q, now lambda times 2 L is the total charge, because the L, it is on this side, because it's a length 2L here. So lambda times 2L is the charge per unit distance square, and this is our basic definition of the electric field. So it means that our approximation is right. And when we say that L goes to infinity, like when L is very very greater than z, like the distance, when the line segment is infinite, we say that L goes to infinity, then what will happen here? I can just convert this one to an infinite wire. So look here, this L, taking this L square common from here, it will be, this one will come out to be, let me do it here. So this E is approximately in the limit L goes to infinity will be approximately equal to 2 lambda in L here, and then take 4 pi epsilon naught while Z here, and this will come out, take L square common, so out of the square root only L will come out, and then it will be 1 plus L, because we have taken that common, so Z square over L square and square root. This L is going to cancel with this L, while this term which we have is n is going to infinity, so this term will go to 0, and 1 plus 0 is 1 and square root of this, so this whole square root term goes to 1, and we are left with this one, that electric field is 2 lambda divided by 4 pi epsilon naught and 1 over Z here. So I can write in a fancier way this one, that electric field in such a situation will be equal to 1 over 4 pi epsilon naught and 2 lambda over Z here. And this is what we were supposed to expect from an infinite line. So with this, or this example is done, and I hope that you will be able to solve problem 2.3 and the onward problem like 2.4 and 5 and 6 and 8 for different kind of geometries, while the basic principles will be like this one.